Alright, after dedicating nearly a year to learning Unreal Engine, it's time to create my own game inspired by the CSGO for free. Let's dive into the details. Throughout this journey, I've been heavily relying on Unreal Engine and Blender for tasks like cinematics and more. About 4 months ago, I started learning Blueprint programming to create my own complete game. To kick things off, I needed an FPS gun. Now, for the best results, you need to use high quality assets. So I used a fantastic free plugin by Infima Games that provided excellent FPS shooting mechanics. They even had a starter map with rifle logic. I studied making the rifle actually fire the bullets that affects the enemies. Now onto the AI friends, I decided to utilize a free advanced locomotion pack, which came with pre-made AI logic. I imported it into my game and began working on the damage and death mechanics, stuff like that. For the death animations, I made use of Unreal Engine's Rectal Physics, which is so cool.
Nice.
I also equipped the AI with weapons and implemented logic for them to fire at the player. It was exciting to see everything coming together. Next up, designing the game level. I started by blocking out a simple TDM type map and strategically placed the AI in various locations. Everything seems to be working fine except for the AI. They could see me through the walls, didn't stop shooting, and had trouble following me. I tried various methods to rectify these issues but couldn't achieve the desired results. That's when I made the bold decision to create my own AI boards from scratch. To bring my custom AI boards to life, I hired free characters and started adding the necessary logic. I wanted that to be more advanced and not easily distracted. That's where behavior tree came into play. I learned about behavior tree and its ability to make AI more advanced. Ryan's YouTube channel was a valuable resource offering informative playlists on game development and behavior tree. Armed with this knowledge, I enhanced the AI's capabilities. Big thanks to Ryan. Then adding EQS navigation points to the environment became crucial to guide the AI. By setting specific points of interest, I directed the AI to focus on certain areas. Then I incorporated shooting and damage logic, created death animations for the player, and added captivating sounds. A breakthrough moment arrived when I realized that our AI couldn't shoot us through walls anymore and started properly following us, just as we intended. With the resolve, it was time to find a captivating map for the game because my previous map didn't work really well. I even threw in some GTA 5 inspired death screens and sounds. After hours of research, I found this pre-Egyptian map. I imported the map into my project and started working on it to ensure a comfortable experience for our AI, minimizing potential bugs, stuff like that. As for team logic, I implemented it just like in a TDM game. I assigned red and blue team logic to the AI, ensuring that they couldn't harm or kill their teammates. I applied the same logic to the main player character. To enhance the visual experience, I added tracers to our weapon, provide a cool visual effect whenever we fire. The Now that everything was almost set up, it was time to design widgets for the game, including a start menu and other elements. I created some sleek start menu widgets and even came up with a catchy name for my game. Finally, the moment of truth had arrived. It was time to play our game. As you can see, I am pleased with the final output of my first game. Throughout the development process, I encountered numerous challenges, and sometimes solving small problems would consume an entire day.
What is that?
That's the reason this game project took more than 30 days to be finished. But that doesn't mean you can't create a game by yourself. It simply requires a lot of patience and hard work. Currently, I've been trying to package this game, but I'm facing technical issues that are preventing me from completing it. Nonetheless, I am actively working to resolve our errors and I hope to package a game soon. One more thing, in the future, I'll be creating some truly awesome tutorials about game development. So make sure to subscribe to my channel.
Nice.
It won't cost you anything. Thank you so much for watching. Take care and have a nice day.